Professor Elizabeth Dabar, who is the Secretary of the Australian Nursing and Midwifery Federation's South Australian Branch.
Such an important event, and congratulations to the organisers and all of you for getting out to support such an important issue. The Australian Nursing and Midwifery Federation, who I represent, we represent nurses, midwives, care workers, students in nursing and midwifery, and of course those who are working in undergraduate employment. Australia is often referred to as the lucky country, but that's not the complete phrase, which is drawn from a book of the same name. Our weather, our lifestyle, our natural resources and our history are envied by many, which is a result of us being referred to as the lucky country. And our universities too are very fortunate in many ways. We have the third highest number of universities in the global top 100, rivaled only by the United Kingdom and of course also the US. But what many people don't know, as I mentioned, that quote about being the lucky country has a further part. The quote actually says, Australia is a lucky country run by second-rate people who share its luck. Perhaps, on those who run our country, perhaps not by your cause. I don't think we would struggle to come up with some second-rate decisions that fall squarely on the shoulders of our politicians. And ripping $2.3 million from our universities is certainly a second-rate decision. And at worst, it sends a loud and clear message to current and future university students that our politicians do not value the importance of education, nor do they acknowledge its role in developing a strong and competitive global economy. Yeah. Australia already ranks near the bottom of the OECD countries for public investment in universities. We are the 25th out of 29. That's pretty low. Yeah. Between 1995 and 2009, other OECD countries grew public investment in tertiary education by 62%. Australia grew its investment by 17%, and for the 10 years between 1995 and 2005, it didn't grow at all.
Shame!
The failure to adequately value tertiary education is not something unique to the current government. Our politicians have been making second-rate decisions for years. But the plan to rip $2.3 billion from the university sector is the latest in a raft of cuts that are just abysmal. I fear personally that this will have dire effects on the nursing and midwifery community and professions that we work so hard to represent. It's predicted by the year 2025 we will be 109,000 nurses and midwives short across Australia. In addition, or alone, in South Australia by the year 2020 we will be between 2,000 and 4,000 nurses and midwives short in this state alone. And an already overstretched health system will struggle even further to cope. And currently, at the same time, we have a short-term oversupply of new graduating nurses and midwives, meaning the number of new graduates are not able to secure jobs. Yet successive governments have done extremely little to do anything about this situation and are not retaining those graduating nurses and midwives, but at the same time are slashing services in health, so there are even less jobs to go around. In 2012, only 50% of graduates in South Australia made it into graduate programs in the SA public health system, and so 280 of our hard-working and dedicated nurses and midwives were left in limbo. And by failing to provide these graduates with jobs, we risk the loss of a whole generation of nurses and midwives with a workforce shortage into the future. We know that governments are not only making it difficult for those nurses and midwives to find work, but they're making it harder generally for people to access tertiary education. Commonwealth funding per student fell by 23% in real terms from 1995 to 2010, from $11,400 per student to $8,800 per student. And at the same time, class sizes have ballooned, the number of full-time university staff has shrunk, And our position is that any moves that make undertaking university study more difficult than it already is should be absolutely opposed. Our governments must work together to increase the number of places in both public and non-public and non-government sectors so that nursing and midwifery people will be available for the community into the future. We must invest in our tertiary education to make university study more accessible and available for nurses and midwives, because who otherwise would be there to care for us in the community in the future? We must also ease the crippling financial pressure so that so many are exposed to as a result of study. It is absolutely disgraceful that two-thirds of university students live below the poverty line.
Shame!
Shame! Our view is, if we fail to address these issues, the lucky country that we are said to be, our luck may well run out. And I ask you, does it make sense to rip $2.3 billion out of our education system? No! Does it make sense to fail to support a future health workforce?
No!
Will we stand together and fight against this attack?
Yes!
Well then, there certainly remains some hope for all of us to continue to live in a lucky country, perhaps occasionally with some very good decisions to make sure we stay lucky. Thank you. Yeah.